Hey folks, what's up? Jeremy Shafer here. Check out my new pair of elf shoes. This is a rather simple model that I just designed, and it's from a single square sheet of paper, no cuts, and it spins. Want to learn how to fold them? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this model, we're going to use a single square, and let's begin white side up, and let's valley fold diagonally in half. Try to make really exact folds, and crease sharply. And now let's unfold and rotate 90 degrees and let's fold diagonally in half in this direction. And unfold. And now let's fold this corner to the middle. And let's repeat on the other three corners. So rotate and just fold all the corners to the middle. This is called a blintz fold. And guess what? We're gonna do another blintz. So rotate and fold all four corners to the middle again. Okay, now let's unfold these four corners. And let's unfold two opposite corners. All right, so we just have these two corners folded. And now let's fold this edge to this crease. So just fold up like this. Make sure that it comes right to this point. And when you do that, you might want to hold the paper down so that it doesn't accidentally slide. Like that. And let's repeat on this side. So let's fold this edge to this crease. Okay, and let's rotate 180 degrees and let's repeat on this side. So let's fold this edge to this crease. And let's fold this edge to this crease. And now let's turn over top to bottom. And let's rotate 90 degrees and let's fold in half. Okay. Now, holding like this, we're going to slide this corner out. So just grab onto it and let the layers slide out and down, just like that. So that's what it should look like. And let's repeat on this side. So hold right here and slide this corner out and flatten. Now let's rotate 180 degrees and let's fold this corner, well actually these two corners, fold them up right on these two points. Like that. And now let's fold this whole flap up to this line. So we're folding this edge to this edge. And try to keep the layers down. All right, now let's unfold the two flaps and let's fold them behind this edge. Just wrap them over the edge like that. And now let's zoom in and let's fold this flap over right on this line. So we're folding this whole shoe. This is gonna be opened into a shoe. Over like this and unfold. And let's do the same thing on this side. And unfold. And now let's stick both of these two-dimensional shoes straight up like this. And now we're going to three-dimensionalize them. So stick your finger in and just burrow in, try to make this pocket as open as possible. And now let's press right here so that this is flat, well, curved. And let's press right here. We're just pinching this point of the shoe like that, so that it stays open. And now let's push this point in. Well, first let's hold like this and pull a little bit. So when you pull, then it opens it out a little bit and you can press it down just like that. And that three-dimensionalizes it a little bit. And try to make this a nice curve. Just sculpt the shoe, sculpt it to taste. And now let's open this pocket and try to put your finger in. Be careful not to tear the paper right here. So just open it. So just put your finger in carefully like that and burrow out a hole. This is what the hole should look like from this angle. And pull here and just shape it to taste. Let's squeeze right here. I'm going to turn it over so you can see more what I'm doing. I'm trying to sort of fold these edges to that crease, like that. Okay, turning back over. So it's just sort of making a nice curvature here. And you can curve it more, like you can make it curve up like this. But if you do, well, this is going to be just flat. No toes are going to be able to fit in this point. But, you know, it's just a stylistic look. You could also just have it point out like that, and that's sort of three-dimensional. I like that, like that. But if you want it to spin better, you might want to point them up and make them also look more elfish. I don't know. It's up to you. Okay, let's work on the other shoe. So open this pocket like this and press right here and pull these two parts apart and press there and open the pocket. Like that, and sculpt it just angle it up like this. If you want to make it really round, you can do a wrinkle fold, which is you hold it like this and you just wrinkle it down like that, and then you see how that just really curves it. Okay, and now let's fold this flap down. And we can fold it just about right on this crease, or maybe a little bit further up. That's really to taste. If you want a wide shoe, you'll fold it further. Yeah, sure, why not? Fold it on the crease. my feet are wide. Not like they're actually going to be able to fit in these shoes, but anyway, so that's what it looks like. This can be a stand so that the shoes will incline a little bit. You know, like in the shoe store, they usually incline a little bit like that. And okay, let's try to make it spin. So what you want to do is you want to try to make this as flat as possible, this surface, all except for these points. So let's just fold that down. And in order to make it so that it doesn't come back up, if you put a little pinch right there, then that might help keep this flat down. Or you could just say, stay down. Okay, so there it is. And now, to make this a little bit less flimsy, because if you balance it on the point right here, then it'll kind of just press down. What you can do is you can do this little fold. Okay, so I had to check to see what I did. Okay, what you do is you just fold this up like this, and let's do the same thing on this edge. Fold it down like this, and now just pinch like that. And you see, that just creates a little bit more of a pointy point that will hopefully support the weight of the shoes and spin. Oh, and also make sure that it's folded like this. If you look like this, you see this isn't going to spin well because this is sticking out. So I'm going to push it down like that, and looking from here, I'm just making sure that this is reasonably level so it'll spin on this point. All right, let's see how it spins. So when you spin it, I guess the idea is to spin it from the points of the shoes. So, and it might also help to zoom out. That way you'll see that they really are spinning. Oh, now they just spin right in one place. I should zoom back in. Okay. Oh, now I can't do it anymore. There we go. All right, well, at least they look pretty nice. So there it is, the elf shoes. And if you think that they don't fit, well, you're wrong. They fit my fingers. Ch-ch-ch. And we can do a little dance or a little jump, a little skip. Well, we can't really skip, but we can we can waddle. All right, have a happy time with your elf shoes. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Whoosh.